Hello friends, this is V. Pushpam Savaresh from Ramco Institute of Technology. In this video, we will present to you a project that we are working on the from past 25 days during our internship in Brandeis University. Our project name is Emotional Recognition Using EEG Signals. In our project, we are dealing with the emotional recognition using EEG signals. Emotion plays a significant and a powerful role in the everyday life of human beings. The importance of emotions in human-to-human interaction provided the basic for the researchers in the computer engineering and the artificial intelligence. The need and importance of the automatic emotion recognition from EEG signals has grown with the increasing role of brain computers, interfacing applications and the development of new forms of human-centric and human-brain interaction with the digital media. In recent years, more and more researchers have started to use electroencephalogram EEG signals in the recognizing emotion because they are reliable. EEG's high temporal resolution provided large amount of useful information in analyzing the human real emotional state directly. Several machine learning techniques have been used for the classifying EEG data. Some common ones that previously have been used for EEG data associated with the affective or emotional states are KNN, K nearest neighbor, LR logical regression, SVM support vector machines, ANN artificial neural network, PCA principal compound analysis, RF random forest, XGBoot and long term short memory LSTM data collection. We gathered the data from the 1 channel and 4 channel EEG signals using the NeuroSky MindWay and the MUSE2 devices. This is NeuroSky MindWay 2 and this is the MUSE2. NeuroSky technology allows for the low-cost EEG linked research and products by using the inexpensive dry sensor. Older EEG required the applications of the conductive gel between the sensor and the head. The system also included built-in the electrical noise reduction software or hardware and utilizing embedded solution for the signal processing and output. The device measures brain activity via 4 electroencephalography EEG sensor. MUSE is worn over the ear and connect to a comparison mobile app via Bluetooth. The use of the MUSE enables the use of biofeedback different from the devices like thank that climb to actual after the brainwaves by wearing it. From the devices, we collected information with video clips of duration 1 to 3 minutes of different emotions and we started to do pre-processing technique.
Hello guys, I am Manoj from SRK IT. I am here to tell you about the pre-processing technique of our project. Before the data can be used in our program, it has to be pre-processed. One of the important steps in pre-processing is to remove the noises and artifacts. This is done by bandpass filtering. The brain produces electrical activities in order of microvolts. Because of the signals are very weak, it is usually contains lot of noise. Sources of noises are static electricity and electromagnetic fields. EEG signals are recorded over various positions on the scalp, are usually contaminated with the noises and artifacts. The complete removal of artifacts will also remove some important information from the EEG signals. This is one of the reasons why we are considering the experiments is required to be interpret EEG signals clinically. A couple of methods are available in the literature to avoid the artifacts in EEG signals. However, removing the artifacts entirely is impossible in existing data acquisition process. We also labeled the data which we are collected. We eliminated the null values to enhance the data. We also eliminated the first and last seconds of our total video of duration 5 seconds of stimuli presentation. This was in order to narrow down the exact required data. The reason why the step was to focus on valuable data and filtering out the extra, because when a picture is displayed, it takes some time for the brain to react to the stimuli, and therefore the first second is usually noisy. The noise that is present in EEG signals can be removed by a simple filters. Artifacts can also be removed by these filters. Now we go through the feature extraction technique. A wide range of features were used for emotional recognition from EEG signals that has been proposed in the past. A wide range of features are used in our project Emotional Recognition Using EEG Signals. This has been proposed in the past. We generally distinguish the feature extraction methods in time domain, frequency domain, time and frequency domain, multi-electrode features and connectivity features. We conducted experiments on one channel EEG signals and four channel EEG signals. In our experiment, we used the data set with the fast Fourier transform FFT, which is a feature extraction technique. The fast Fourier transform technique is an algorithm that computes with the discrete Fourier transform of the sequence and inverse. Fourier analysis converts the signals from original domain to represent the frequency domain and vice versa. The DFT is obtained a decomposition a sequence of values into components of different frequencies. The operations is usually in many fields, but computing it directly from the definition is often too slow to be practical. Now we look into the classifiers that have been used in our project.
Hey guys, this is Girdhar from Bennett University. I'm the last member of our team 20. My part is to pick the best classifier which gives us the best prediction so that we could get better accuracy to predict the emotions of using the EEG signals. And I had tried different classifiers and I'm going to show you the how much accuracy I have got. The first classifier which I have used is KNN. The KNN is the K means nearest neighbor algorithm. So it uses mainly on the Euclidean distance. The main disadvantage of this, it can't rely on the more data set, higher data set or higher dimensions. If there are any simple or null values, it can't be able to detect. The accuracy for our KNN means is for one channel, that is this one, and the four channel is this. The second classifier which I have used is SVM. SVM is the support vector machine. Support vector machine can be also used for our data set. There is a multi-class classification, but the disadvantage is that is because it takes more time than the neural networks. So the accuracy for one channel is that is this. Accuracy for the four channel is this. The third classifier which I have used is logistic regression. The logistic regression can also be used in our dataset, but it's mainly focuses on binary classification. It can be used for larger dataset also, but yes, it is being a binary classification method, a classifier. So we can be mainly focused on logistic regression. So we shifted to the another classifier. Thank you. And for one channel, our accuracy for the logistic regression is this. For four channel, the logistic regression, our accuracy of the logistic regression is this. We have tried different classifiers. That is, XGBoost we got an for one channel accuracy that is this, and for four channel we had an accuracy of XGBoost is this, and we tried different classifiers like ANN, PCA, random forest, and LSTM. And these are all the accuracies of remaining four classifiers. And as part of the project, the one which we got the higher accuracy is our model. So we chosen the LSTM, which we got the more accuracy. LSTM is the long short term memory. Long short term memory is the best classifier which we have chosen because it's mainly targets on multi-level classification. First thing, and second one is the it has a more dense layers. It is a neural network, and it has a different activation functions. And we have used the TANH and sigmoid for the classification, and we have used one hot encoding also for classification to reduce the multi-level classification. And we have used dropouts, dense dot dropouts, so that if there are equivalent to the getting the accuracy, so it will just drop the weights, it will just drop the values. So to get a better accuracy, we choose the LSTM. The final part of our video is conclusion. Thus we can conclude that LSTM has the better is the best classifier to predict the emotions using the EEG signals. So for one channel, the LSTM accuracy is 87.74%, and for four channel, LSTM accuracy is 91.32%. As it is a research field, we try to mainly focus on the classifiers, which classes will give us the better accuracy, and we have achieved that one with the LSTM. And we can do emotions, we can predict the emotions using the other methods like facial. But the original emotions which we can generate through is EEG signals only, because the stimuli which you are reacting can be calculated using your brain signals. So you cannot cheat you cannot cheat like the other emotions, facial emotions. So Thank you, Living India, for giving this part. Thank you.